What's up, fans? It's KP. I am styling here at Dragon Con with some of our favorite pirates, Pintel and Marty from Pirates of the Caribbean. How are you, Lee?
Oh, awesome, dude. Having a great time at this convention, man. It's off the hook, the craziness.
You got quite a crowd here, Marty. How are they treating you so far?
Oh, it's been a pretty good show. The down south are really good people, so it's been a great show.
Well, we just caught the costume parade, and I got to say, a large portion of those were Pirates fans. Marty, how are you reacting to not only the hardcore fans, but so many of them?
Well, we're kind of used to it now after like 5 or 6 years we've been doing this. So I've only seen one ever dressed like me, so that's a good. It was like a six-year-old little girl too. So no, it's cool. I mean, it is part of our life. We can't get away from it. Not that we want to get away from it, but it's cool to see people really, you know, love your work. And
it's one of the pleasures of doing what we do, to get out and meet the fans. They're the ones that make us who we are. So I think it's cool when they run into us. We really appreciate them. And, you know, we'll come, we tell it like it is, we're honest with them, we tell the real stories. And so it's a great connection to have, especially with Pirates of the Caribbean, because when the movie was first made, people were like, oh, it's about pirates and it's about a theme park ride. And it was the fans that elevated us to the mega hit. That and Johnny's performance in the first flick really kind of took us to the stratosphere. So we owe a big debt to our fans, for sure.
You know, you could be 4 years old, and or you could be 400 years old. This movie touches everybody in the right place. And obviously, more of our fans are kids than anything. Well, women, obviously, because of Johnny and Orlando. But I think kids make up more than 60% of the fans, you know, out there.
And like you say one funny thing and make people laugh across America or the world, they remember that. They remember those moments. But there's a great power in what we do and a great responsibility, you know, as well.
Both Lee and I do a lot of children hospitals. We see these kids that are, you know, the terminally ill. And just when you walk into a room and they know, oh my God, I've seen you as a pirate. You know.
So there's a saying that everyone will meet a celebrity once in their life and have a 2-minute encounter. Well, like, if you're going through life as the celebrity, you have to remember that. And so give that person their 2 minutes. You got the time, and they'll remember it forever.
It's much more about touching somebody's heart than it is about whatever we're taking home to the bank. I mean, I'd much rather make somebody smile than make myself smile.
We're in such an ego business that it's really good to, like, go the other way with the energy once in a while. Because it's like, if it's all about you all the time, it's like, who really gives a shit? You know what I mean? So to be able, with our fans, they just want that connection. And we get that straight from Johnny. Johnny was the first person I ever said that the fans are the boss. You know, and when you're on that level and you realize that that's what got you there, then guys, at the character level that we are, I think that's a real valuable lesson for us, you know? And so I take it very much to heart. They say be nice to everyone on the way up, you might need them on the way down. So for he and I, you know, you ask the universe to give you a part in a great movie, are you gonna complain about spending 2 years in the Caribbean, going to work on a speedboat, you know, dressing like a pirate? Hey, you know what? I don't carry a hammer, I carry a sword, baby. You know, it doesn't get much better than that, you know?
We see him dressed up, you know, pirates coming down the street one after another after another. You have any great war stories about the fans that have come up to you and what they've shared about what you've meant to them?
Well, the crazy thing for me is, you know, I have my catchphrase, my hello, puppet. And I can't tell you how many times I've heard that is like a foreplay, a term of foreplay now, you know? So when I have like a 75-year-old guy going, I say, hello, puppet, when I'm about to get it on with my honey, I'm like, dude, that is TMI, bro.
You know? It might be a nice little Viagra line, right? Like something like,
I'm available for Viagra if they are Cialis. It's like, it's an L.O. Poppin' moment, you know? L.O. Poppin'.
I gotta believe there's some funny, hardcore women fan stories.
Yeah, but we can't talk about that on here, so.
Well, thank you so much. Marty Kleba, thank you so much. Lee Ehrenberg, there you go. More to come from Dragon Con. I'm KP. I am Stylin', stylinonline.com.
Action figures, you can do birthday parties with plates, and I think Johnny's got shampoo, you know? So you know you've made it when you become an action figure, so.
The ones that people call me on, Tales of the Crypt that I did years ago with the Q-tip. I have a thing with either jamming things or breaking things.
All of a sudden, if you get real big, and all of a sudden now you don't have time for people, then you're in the wrong business, you know? You know what I mean?
To me, school teachers, the garbage collector, the woman that cleans my house has more importance on a daily basis than any of us, you know?
Battlestar Galactica.
Batman. Yeah.
Serenity.
Boba Fett.
Highlander.
The Empire Strikes Back.
Doctor Who.
Star Trek The Next Generation was my favorite.
Scooby-Doo.
Well, at the moment, it would be True Blood.
True Blood.
True Blood.
I have to say True Blood, too.
She-Ra.
Doctor Who.
Star Wars, Episode 4.
Firefly, without a doubt.
Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Joker, obviously.
Family Guy.
Good choice.